Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. Sitting here at the desk and have the gem sitting here. I've done a bunch of videos in the last week about this little machine. I've been having a real blast with this little thing. It's such a little tiny machine and it's completely original. And I got it at a really good price. I got it for $261 plus shipping. So altogether it was less than $300. And the guy was selling it for parts. I bought it on eBay. The guy was selling it for parts. The machine's complete, and the only thing wrong with it was that somebody had gotten in there and just really mucked about. And it was so far out of adjustment it wouldn't run, period. There was no way this machine was going to run the way it was set up. And so I got it running, and it's fairly quiet for a gym. It has a great spring in it. It really does. And it has a lot of power. It'll play, you hear all these stories about a gym won't make it through one single plane. This will play almost two complete cylinders on a full wind. And the speed control's on the side. It's also the on-off switch. And the machine runs fairly smoothly. A lot of these machines sound like lawnmowers when they're running, but this one actually sounds fairly good. It can still be quieter. I still got some more adjustments to do to it, but all in all, I've been really, really pleased with it. It's a lot of fun to play with. But this is a rather special video tonight because I have something that I wanted to show you. As you know, I've been working on the Canophonic Edison recorder. It's an improvement to the original design. Set up basically the same way. Not exactly the same, and I can't tell you the constituents of it yet. But I've been doing a lot of experiments, and you've heard the recordings that I've been making. And I just want everybody to know, because I've gotten a lot of emails, people asking me about these recorders, when are they going to be available, can I buy them, and I just want everybody to know that it is not the recorder that's going to allow you to record music the way that I've been copying cylinders and making custom cylinders. The recorder has a lot to do with it, but the recorder by itself is not going to allow you to make custom cylinders or copy cylinders or anything like that. There's a much larger process involved in doing this. The MP3 Canophonic process is not just the recorder. There's much more to it. I'm not going to go into any details about it because I'm not going to reveal the constituents yet of how I'm doing these recordings. The point of this video tonight is I built a new recorder and I wanted to unveil this. And this one I'm going to show you. And this is the Canophonic Voice Recorder. And you will see that it is a bit different than the original Edison design. The overall design is approximately the same, using completely different materials. That is one of the most important factors in this recorder. And it was this recorder that made me want to get the gem. I wanted to have a little machine that I could use as a portable recorder, where I could just carry this little machine around with me, throw a cylinder on it, throw a speaking tube on it, and a blank cylinder, and make a fairly decent recording. Limited only, of course, by the size of the machine. But what I'm going to do tonight, actually this morning, it is now 1 a.m., and I've been in here since 11 o'clock this afternoon. And I spend, as I've probably said, hours and hours and hours working on this process, designing recorders, building recorders, tearing them apart, rebuilding them, tearing them apart, rebuilding them again, trying to find a really efficient recorder for use on the Edison cylinder phonograph. I have found one, and even though I've built and made recordings with recorders that were similar to this, I guarantee you, you've never heard anything like you're about to hear. And that's why I wanted to do this video using the gem. I mean, this is the smallest, least expensive Edison cylinder phonograph that was ever designed or built. And yet, in a few minutes, we're going to make a recording on this that is going to rival a tape recorder. And I'm not kidding in the slightest. And we're going to be using a speaking tube, a moldy brown wax cylinder, and I've left some mold on this. Now, I bought a ton of these things, a ton of them being a relative term. I bought 50 of them, and I still got 30 some of them left. And they were so moldy, I mean, you could hear absolutely nothing on them, solid noise. But as you shave through them, they're getting smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. And so when I started doing the experiments, I just left them moldy. I shaved them enough so I could record on them. You know, as long as I could actually hear what kind of recording I was getting, I wasn't really concerned with the background noise. So this one's got some noise on it, but I think you're going to be quite surprised with the results of this recorder. So we're going to install the new recorder on the gem, tighten it down, install a still moldy brown wax cylinder, close the end gate. The machine's fully wound. Let it run. I've noticed that if you want to take the a bit of the tension off the spring, let it run for about 15 or 20 seconds. And that takes a lot of the warble out. Surprisingly enough, it's because the spring is wrapped so tightly, as it's beginning to unwrap, it chatters a bit. And you can hear it right there. And then it stops, and then it runs much more stable. So when I share, when I fully wind it, I don't fully wind it. About 6, 8, 10, 12 turns, depending on how far out it's run. So in any case, I just wanted to do a quick cylinder recording, just to give you some idea of what this new recorder is going to sound like. And I think you're going to be impressed with it. When I got this one finished, I was astounded at the sound that was coming out of this little tiny Edison cylinder phonograph. And you don't have to yell, you don't have to raise your voice. You speak in a timbre that's slightly louder than normal, about like I'm doing now, because I'm talking to this camera and it's, you know, 4 feet away. And I'm recording this with my webcam. And as I've said 1,000 times, webcams are fairly decent cameras if you put enough light on them. And if you put enough light on them, they make decent video, and you can record it directly to your computer. So I've got the Canophonic voice recorder on the Edison Gem phonograph, and the machine is wound. We're going to install our speaking tube, and I'm going to make a really, really loud, crisp, and clear recording on this little, tiny, wind-up phonograph. I think you're going to be impressed, and I think you're really, really going to like this. This is, if I say so myself, this is really cool, but I've put months now into developing this entire series of new recorders for the Edison cylinder phonograph. This one is strictly a voice recorder to be used with either a speaking tube or a recording horn. So the machine's wound, blank wax cylinder, the recorder is installed. Let's make a cylinder recording on the Edison Gem phonograph using a speaking tube. Hello, this is Benjamin, making a quick test recording on the Edison Gem cylinder phonograph. This is approximately 1901, 1906, really difficult to say the exact date it was manufactured. But I'm recording on the Edison Gem phonograph. I'm recording on a very old shaved brown wax cylinder. I'm recording with my speaking tube, and I'm using the Canophonic voice recorder. This is the new Edison 2-minute recorder that I've designed exclusively for recording the voice using either a speaking tube or a recording horn. It took a lot of development to be able to design and build a 2-minute recorder that was much more sensitive than the original design, and allowed you to make a fairly good recording without having to yell or scream or screech or speak in a tone that was unnatural. And this makes you a recording that sounds actually quite clear and quite natural, because you don't have to yell. You don't really have to raise your voice or make really precise pronunciations to make a good recording. The recorder does quite well. It's very efficient. And even recording with just a simple speaking tube, these recordings are coming out very loud, very crisp, and very clear. So this is Benjamin the Victrola Guy making a quick recording on the Edison Gem Cylinder Phonograph. It is May the 9th, I believe now, 2012. It is now Tuesday morning. It is 1:20 a.m. doing a test recording on the Edison Gem, recording on an original brown wax cylinder, using my speaking tube, recording on a very, very old cylinder that's been slightly shaved, still has some noise on it, and using the new Canophonic 2-minute voice recorder. All right, so we stop the machine, remove the speaking tube, pull off the cylinder, and you can see it is just absolutely covered with swarf. Much more than I'm sure you've ever seen before in any video I've ever made of doing a standard voice recording. So before I do anything else, I want to remove my recorder, put it back in its box, you're going to be impressed with this. I can guarantee you that. I know that probably sounds egotistical and arrogant, but I put a lot of work into developing this new recorder. Months and hours and hours and hours of sitting in this room, actually sitting at my workbench over there, and building recorders from scratch, waiting days for the adhesives to completely dry, make a test recording and find out that it doesn't work at all. It's so disappointing, and then you start from scratch and you progress and you make notes and you test, and it's sometimes been really, really discouraging. But when you come up with something that works, I mean, this, I can guarantee you, is going to be a really, really excellent recording considering what we recorded it on. So let me blow this swarf away. And then I've got a new brush. For a swarf brush, I'm now using this fan brush. And this really works. Now remember, this cylinder had some mold left on it. So it's still going to have some noise. But even with the noise, I can guarantee you this is going to be the loudest acoustic recording you have ever heard. This was recorded with a speaking tube. Now, I install the cylinder back on the machine. We'll give it a couple of cranks. There's 10 or 11. A Model C reproducer. Let's grab a 14.5-inch Witch's Hat horn that I just blew swarf all over. Now, I think you're going to be really impressed with the results. I was. Play this back, but this is a very, very loud recording considering that I was just talking into a hollow tube. And you don't have to yell, and you don't have to scream, you don't have to raise your voice. And I'm recording on a cylinder that is still partially covered in mold, and I shaved it just enough to give me a surface to record on. And that way I can still record another dozen or so times on it. But I think you will agree that for a standard acoustic recording using a Edison Gem phonograph and a 14.5-inch witch's hat horn, that was a very, very loud recording. Which means this new recorder is efficient, it's effective, it cuts some really pronounced grooves. I don't know if I can get a shot of these or not. Probably not. But very pronounced grooves cut into the cylinder. And that is what makes the difference. And you can look at this cylinder. In fact, if you look across it, you can actually see peaks and valleys. And this cylinder is still partially covered with mold. And yet you heard for yourself that it made a really, really decent recording. So these experiments I have done have paid off, and I'm really, really pleased with the results. So we're in the process right now of getting some new styluses. And the problem with these Edison recorders, of course, is that you can find the bodies everywhere, and you can find the mica diaphragms, but no one is making a recording stylus. Nobody. There are none available. Period. Nowhere. Until now. So the new recording styluses are going to be made of ruby rod, not sapphire. We're going to be using ruby. And we're negotiating with the manufacturer now, and I'm hoping that, as I mentioned, there's a lot of stuff going on. There's new cylinders that are going to be coming out in just the next few days. In fact, I'm hoping that something is going to show up tomorrow. And as I said, the first cylinder we're going to produce are going to be purple. is going to be pretty cool. So new cylinders, new recorders, the Canophonic voice recorder. When the styluses are here, this is the kind of results you're going to be getting. And if you can get this kind of result on a gem, then imagine what it's going to sound like if you're going to be recording on a Standard or a Fireside or a Home or a Triumph or virtually any other Edison machine. But getting that kind of sound out of an acoustic recorder on an Edison gem using a moldy brown wax cylinder was pretty good, if I do say so myself. And I've, as I said, I've spent months working on this process. Not just the voice recorders, but there's other recorders as well. So I just wanted to show you what I've been up to and let you know that these recorders are going to be on their way. And hopefully what the point of doing this is, there's so many people who have contacted me and they said, you know, I've got a recorder but it's missing the stylus, or I've got the stylus and it's detached, or I've got the stylus and the diaphragm's missing, and I've got all of it, and how do I put it back together and make it work? And it isn't just throwing this thing together and putting it on your machine and expecting to get a recording out of it. Most of the recorders you buy on eBay aren't going to work. I mean, they will make a recording, but they're not going to make a recording like this. I guarantee you that. And regardless of what recorder you have, you're not going to be able to copy cylinders, and you're not going to be able to record music, and you're not going to be able to make copies of anything other than you talking. You will not be able to record music, except live music, of course, with a recording horn. You can record piano or someone speaking or laughing or telling a story or singing or playing the guitar, but you will not be able to record music by using a speaker or pointing it at a stereo or having a big horn, you know, pointed at a stereo speaker and expect to play a song into it and be able to record and get a decent recording. That is not how it works. But as far as voice recordings, I'm hoping to have these recorders ready soon, and we'll be offering a service where if you have the body, you can send the body in, we can rebuild the recorder using the Canophonic process and send it back, and you will have an absolutely spectacular voice recorder that will far exceed anything that Edison ever produced. And I dare you to compare the recorder that you just heard to any Edison recorder you can find. If you can find one that's brand new in the box, it will not do what this one just did. I promise you that. It will not. And I'm not trying to brag. I'm just stating a fact. It won't. I put a lot of work into this. I'm not trying to beat Edison's design. Trying to improve it. Trying to take an acoustic recorder that can make a loud, crisp, clear recording by simply speaking into it rather than yelling into it. And I've accomplished that. It's taken an awful lot of work. And as I said, it's now, almost 1:30, and I've been here since 11 this afternoon, so it's been a long day. And I have two recorders I'm working on. One is drying under an ultraviolet light, and one is just curing. So if you do have any questions or comments on the Canophonic voice recorder, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. I answer all of my email, try to answer it the day I get it. My email is getting really full now, so it may be 3, 4, 5 days before I can get back to you. I've got a lot of stuff going on. The new cylinders will be coming out. The new recorders will be coming out. And what I'm striving to do is, I'll be producing custom blank cylinders, custom order cylinders, copies of original cylinders, very much like Vulcan is doing in England, but this is still going to be one at a time. I'm not going to start producing plastic cylinders as they are. I'm concentrating on the recorders themselves and the blank cylinders. But as I said, the The new recorder works extremely well. It's sensitive. It produces a really crisp and clear and loud recording, even on something as small as the Edison Gem. And that was the point. I now have a little, tiny, portable cylinder recorder I can take with me virtually anywhere I want to go. Take the speaking tube and a blank cylinder or two, I can record anything almost anywhere. So that is going to be fun. I'm really looking forward to it. And that was the point. That was the entire point of getting this gem, was for use with this new recorder. So if you do have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.